Tervetuloa taas Kuningaskunnan tuuli-ohjelmasarjan pariin. Lehtimajan juhla lokakuussa 2017 oli hengessä siirtymä kokonaan uuteen aikakauteen. Israelissa järjestettiin Lehtimajan juhlan lopulla koko maailman historian ensimmäinen konferenssi, jonka järjestäjinä toimivat Israelin messiaaniset juutalaiset ja jonne he olivat kutsuneet kansakuntia. Läpimurron takana oli Tyynenmeren kansojen yli 30 vuotta sitten saama näky Jumalan kirkkauden paluusta takaisin Jerusalemiin. Tämä on ensimmäinen kahdesta jaksosta, jossa katsomme lähemmin, millainen läpimurto Israelissa oikein tapahtui.
We really believe that the glory of the Lord is revealed or launched from here in Jerusalem. And I think it will increase, just like the sun rise every morning. You know, every morning the sun rises so gently. And we believe the Lord is coming like that, just gently like the sun every morning. And then His presence and His glory will just increase in intensity day by day by day.
Tässä jaksossa katsomme, millaisen matkan Tyynenmeren kansat ovat tehneet tämän näyn kanssa. Milo Siilata on Tyynenmeren rukousliikkeen koordinaattori ja hän on ollut prosessissa mukana alusta asti.
When Jesus on the Mount of Olives said to the disciples, you know, you shall be my witnesses from Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria and to the end. Actually the Greek is singular, the end of the earth, one end of the earth. So we believe we in the Pacific are the end of the earth. And so we believe that this is the last days and the Lord is coming back to Jerusalem. So it has to start from the ends of the earth where it stopped.
Syksyllä 2017 järjestetyn konferenssin juuret löytyvät Kaukoidästä yli 30 vuoden takaa.
Everything started in 1984 when the first World Prayer Assembly was in Seoul, South Korea. That was organized by some American, you know, big ministries and Korea. And but we really believe that out of that prayer assembly in 1984, 33 years ago now, started many prayer movements around the world, including our little one in the South Pacific. We started very, very small. And so we were just a typical prayer movement. You pray like everyone else. Pray for the kingdom of God, the church, the government, the family, and so on and so on. But then 1986, the Lord gave us, this is a famous vision for us in 1986, called the Deep Sea Canoe Vision, where the Lord kind of gave a blueprint of some sort of movement from the ends of the earth to Jerusalem regarding this glory.
Australialainen pastori Geoff Armitz on myös ollut näynkantajana alusta asti.
Well, the vision really comes back to 1986, a man in the Solomon Islands. Michael Malio was received a vision. They were actually talking about planting churches, and the Lord just opened up this vision. In this vision, he saw a flood in a valley that he recognized from the Solomons. It's a mighty flood, strong flood, but the water was crystal clear with no rubbish. And it came down a valley, and then he was, as he saw it coming down the valley, he was then taken up in the spirit to look down, and as it went over, came to the end of the valley, it came to a dam. And it filled the valley and then overflowed the dam and then became a mist that moved around the whole Pacific region several times. And then he saw the mist coming back to Papua New Guinea, and from Papua New Guinea it changed to become a current, as he described it, like behind a speedboat but no boat. And it started to head off in an easterly direction towards the Americas. And when the currents reached the Americas, one went right up the North Pole, one went right down the South, and one went right across to the east coast of the Americas. And when it got to the east coast of the Americas, it turned up and became a great tsunami that was now moving in a westerly direction. It moved right over both the Americas, from the North Pole to the South, moved right across the whole Pacific, right across into Asia, and then right up into the Arabian Gulf. And then the southern arm stopped. And the northern arms went right over all of Russia, all of Europe, and to Africa, connecting up until Jerusalem was totally surrounded. And then it rushed into Jerusalem and then became, I think, like an atomic bomb. You know, a mighty cloud that rose up out of Jerusalem, and this cloud, this beautiful, glorious cloud, covered the whole earth. And the scripture was given, and the knowledge of the glory of the Lord shall cover the earth as the waters cover the sea.
90-luvun alusta alkaen Tyynen valtameren kansat alkoivat kokoontua joka vuosi yhteen ylistämään ja rukoilemaan.
And we would meet each year and just, you know, we'll pray and say, where are we going to meet next year? And someone says, oh, can we host it? And after a number of years, we realized we were following that vision. We were moving in the Pacific, and we started in Solomon Islands in 91 and 92. 93 we're in Papua New Guinea, 94 in Australia, 95 was New Zealand, 96 was Fiji, 97 Samoa, 98 Tonga, 99 back to Papua New Guinea, 2000 back to Solomon Islands, 2001 back to Fiji, 2002 and 2003 was in Vanuatu, 2004 we were actually at Tahiti, which is the exact opposite. If you put a spear through Jerusalem, you're in Tahiti. And so 2005 New Zealand, 2006 Australia, 2007 Papua New Guinea. And we believe it became a current there. And when that happened, the Prime Minister of Papua New Guinea made a covenant on the opening of our prayer assembly that Papua New Guinea would be in a covenant relationship with the God of Israel, and that the God of Israel would be the God of Papua New Guinea.
Vuonna 2007 tapahtui kuitenkin muutakin merkittävää.
In 2007, 10 years ago, the Lord gave us a revelation that he will enter Jerusalem during Sukkot 2017.
Valmistautuminen tähän jatkui näyn mukaisesti.
2009, we were in Hawaii, 2010 in west coast of America, and then we jumped around, but 2013 we were in the east coast of America, and we believe that was the tsunami. 2014 in Malaysia, Asia, 2015 in Europe, 2016 in Africa, 2017 is in Jerusalem.
But here we are, right now is Sukkot 2017, and we are here to welcome this glory phenomenon.
Salomonsaarelainen profeetta Michael Maliau riemuitsi Jerusalemissa konferenssin läpimurrosta.
So I've been pregnant for 34 years, and I'm the happiest man to see the baby born.
Kun opetuslapset kysyivät Jeesukselta Israelin kuningaskunnan ennalleen asettamisesta, Jeesus siis vastasi puhumalla maailman äärestä. Ei ole sattuma, että tämä näky Jumalan kirkkauden paluusta Jerusalemiin vastaanotettiin juuri Salomonsaarilla. Salomonsaaret oli nimittäin maailman ääressä viimeinen paikka, jonne evankeliumi saapui, ja heti sen jälkeen alkoi Israelin kuningaskunnan ennalleen asettaminen.
And the gospel arrived in Solomon Islands, which was the last to get it, in 1894. And the Zionist movement was birthed just immediately afterwards. The beginning of Israel as a state as we know it today. And we've already lived in and seen the miracle of there being an Israel now, because there was no kingdom to restore to Israel, because there was no Israel and no land, but the Lord has got that.
A lot of what we're doing now is kind of started from the Solomon. We have our main prophet by the name of Michael Maliau from the Solomon. And it makes sense. It had to start there, and then from the ends of the earth, work back, you know, back to Samaria, Judea, and back to Jerusalem. So that's basically, we are just one of the many back to Jerusalem movements in the world.
Ensimmäisellä puoliajalla evankeliumi vietiin maan ääreen, ja nyt menossa olevalla toisella puoliajalla se palaa siis maan äärestä takaisin Jerusalemiin. Samaan aikaan Tyynen valtameren esirukoilijoiden kanssa Israelissa oli myös muita toisen puoliajan joukkueita. Yksi näistä oli singaporelaisen pastori George Annadorain johtama yli 100 hengen esirukoilijaryhmä, joka kirjaimellisesti teki jo tätä paluumatkaa Samariassa.
We from the Far East believe that as we read Acts chapter 1 and verse 8, We believe that what Jesus said, the gospel will go out from Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and the end of the earth. We believe that everything is coming back one full circle, and therefore what went out from Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, end of the earth must come back from the end of the earth and back to Samaria, Judea, and Jerusalem. So we have a task here to accomplish here in Samaria, and that for that reason, the families from the Far East are here from the end of the earth, and we are here to pray and to call upon God to give us a breakthrough, to open the doors, the iron doors, and to allow the gospel of the kingdom to penetrate.
Kaukoidän ja Tyynen valtameren kansat kantavat yhdessä ja erikseen Jumalan kutsua tälle toiselle puoliajalle. George Annadorai iloitsee siitä, mutta häntä vaivasi siinä yksi asia.
The thing that haunted me was, can God forget the West? Will you forget all the good that Europe has done, all the good that America has done? And then the answer I got from Jesus was so very satisfying, so very soothing, that I am looking at the West with wholly different eyes. So I tell my friends in China, it's not just back to Jerusalem movement, it's a back to Jerusalem and beyond. In other words, this whole thing is going back to Jerusalem, but it doesn't end in Jerusalem, it's going to go back to the West, and once again the West will respond. A very different West, a very new West, a very different generation, but the West will once again respond. And they have been bringing the gospel to us, so now we have the responsibility to bring the gospel back to them. But before we bring this back to them, we have to bring the gospel to Israel, and then together with Israel, back to the West, like it began. So this story has a happy ending, where many in the West will once again come to the Lord. And the prayers of many intercessors crying out for revival to break out in America and reformation once again in Europe.
Uudesta Kaledoniasta, Salomon saarilta ja Vanuatulta Israeliin tullut Tyynenmeren saarten väki suoritti puolestaan lehtimajan juhlilla loppuun tähän Salomon saarilla saatuun näkyyn liittyvän tehtävän, jota he olivat valmistelleet yli 25 vuotta. Tyynenmeren rukoilijat ovat paljon etsineet Herran edessä sitä, mistä Jumalan kirkkaudessa oikein on kysymys.
We've had the privilege of say 33 years since the revelation start arriving, and in 1986 more. So as the years goes on, more and more and more revelation. So by 2017 years ago, we have a revelation that the Lord Jesus is now on the planet Earth as the glory of the Father. Not physically, but in the spiritual dimension. So if you just talk about the glory, no problem. No one's going to argue with that. But when you talk about Jesus now manifesting as the glory, we have a lot of problem with that. Because theologically speaking, the church don't expect the Lord Jesus to come until the end of the age. You know, with the rapture and glory and power and everyone see him. We agree. We believe that's still at the end of the age. But how do you explain this phenomenon of the glory, you know, right now? So, you know, we've been searching scriptures to really identify this thing. And basically we have scriptures like Isaiah 60, arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. So we really believe that this is. That this is just the beginning, you know, that the Lord is arising as he promised through the prophet Isaiah, that he one day he will rise like the sun over Israel. you know, drawing the nation and their riches. If you read the whole of Isaiah 60, it's about the kings of the nations, you know, recognizing the glory of Israel, bringing their treasures and all everything else to Israel. So we believe this is at the beginning of that, where the Lord himself will rise like the sun over Israel. Another scripture we found is Malachi 4, the same thing, where on the wicked he will destroy, but on the righteous he will arise, you know, like the sun of righteousness with healing on his wings. So we believe in that. Also Hosea chapter 6, where he talks about him, his coming will be established as sure as the dawn or the morning, and he will come to us like the rain, the latter rain and the former rain. So this is not a dramatic coming like the end of the age with all power and glory and angels and saints. This seems like a very natural, small rising, you know, just like the sun will rise every day. Anyway, that's the best explanation. We're trying to explain, well, trying not explain, we're trying to make sense of what the revelation of the glory on earth right now. So that's because the revelation of the glory has been progressive until now, and we don't claim to know everything. We're not theologians, you know, we're not even that clever kind of thing. We're just honestly trying to understand what God is doing on planet Earth right now. So that's, we really believe the Lord Jesus is coming as the glory of the Father to be revealed in Jerusalem, and it will begin the day of the Lord, then the end times, and preparing the way of the Lord. It's just the beginning. As far as we're concerned, this is just the beginning.
And very briefly, for the knowledge of the glory of the Lord to cover the earth, for all the eyes of the whole world to be open to see the glory of the Lord, the eyes of Israel have to be open first. And so that for all Israel to be saved, and for that veil to be removed, and for Israel to see the Messiah and to receive the Messiah, and the glory to rest on Israel. And as Paul said, if their rejection meant that the gospel went out to the world, what will their acceptance be? But life from the dead. But I believe now is a day for the glory of the Lord to return, and for all Israel to look upon him whom they've pierced. And as their eyes are opened, that's going to be the turbocharge in these last days for all the eyes of the world to be open, and for us to see the greatest harvest into the kingdom of God that the world has ever seen, because the knowledge of the glory of the Lord will cover the earth as the waters cover the sea.
Muutoksen kokoluokkaa kuvaa näky kolmesta Jumalan tunkeutumisesta maaplaneetalle.
And so the first invasion was the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ in Bethlehem. The second invasion was the outpouring of the Holy Spirit on Pentecost. And the third invasion is the glory of the Father revealed in Jerusalem during Sukkot this year. So, you know, when we talk about invasion, some people don't like the word because, you know, conjures up pictures of Normandy, you know, invasion of Europe from England. But if you think about it, when the first invasion, it was just the birth of a baby boy. You know, that's how God invaded the world, through the birth of a baby boy. And the second invasion was outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Only 120 people experienced that. So we're not expecting anything, you know, whatever it's going to do during this Sukkot, we don't know, but it'll be something along that line.
Pitkän valmistautumisen aikana Jeesus on vahvasti kohdannut Tyynenmeren rukoilijoita.
We had a major revelation started in the Solomons to the main prophet of this moment when the Lord Jesus appeared to him just as he appeared as the captain of the armies of the Lord and as he appeared to Joshua back in the book of Joshua. So he appeared to this prophet in the Solomon back in 2003. So since 2003 to this year, 14 years, basically he's been appearing to us in the spiritual realm in four phases: King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the Bridegroom for the Bride, Commander of the Armies of the Lord, and then the Righteous Judge of all the earth. So those are the four phases mainly that the Lord appeared to us, not physically, but in the spiritual realm.
Yllättäen tässä Tyynenmeren kansojen prosessissa kohti Jumalan kirkkauden läpimurtoa on ollut mukana myös iso joukko suomalaisia.
For some reason unknown, Finland has been joining us in the Pacific right from day one. We don't know why, still don't know why, but But somehow Finland always pop up in the Pacific. We were asking, what are these white people doing here in the Pacific? So, but because they've been with us, they really know us. They know our ways, and a lot of, they know a lot of our secret. I think they know too much about us. So anyway, I believe something special is gonna come out of Finland.
Concerning the gospel of salvation, we look to Israel, our fathers. Considering the glory of God, we consider the Pacific our fathers. There are no words that describe our gratitude and honor to our fathers. Jesus Christ, King of glory,
our bright groom,
we offer ourselves.
We offer our continent.
As a living sacrifice.
Holy and acceptable.
To you. This is our spiritual worship. And we ask. That as your bride.
We will fall in love.
So madly. Seeing your sacrifice, that no cost, is too much. So that, all glory, comes to you.
Speaks to us in pictures. And so the Lord said, it's a bit like the sun. When the sun rises every day, it's cooler, you know, but as the sun rises, the intensity of the and the heat of increases. And it goes right, and as it goes up to noon, it gets really, really hot. You know, so the light increases and the heat increases. So we believe that the presence and the glory of the Lord will start to increase. And the intensity of that will increase in the next few years. And he talked to us about another picture is cooking popcorns. You know, we cook popcorn by, you know, put corn in a pot, a bit of oil, you heat it up, and then you can hear the popcorn popping. You know, as the heat increases, things start to pop, 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 pop. And so the Lord said, this year is just the beginning, but he's coming to cook the whole world with his presence and his glory. And the Lord said, you will hear things popping all over the world, like popcorn. And then the Lord said, when his presence will increase like the sun, and when it's the noonday, the hottest time of the day, the Lord said, the last thing we'll see popping, dead bones of believers popping out of their graves. So, you know, he talked to us in simple language that we can understand. And then actually we went to Finland 2 years ago, and he talked to us like a sauna, the principle of the sauna. You know, the Lord said, it's the same thing. The Lord said, when you go into a sauna, you know, normally to have the maximum benefit, you need to take off your clothes, you know, take off the things of the world. Come naked to the presence of the Lord and let the heat of the glory of the Lord heat you up, cook you, to bring all the uncleanness out of you. And he talks about the fire, you know, the fire of God that produced the heat. and the water, the word of God, you know, to produce a steam. So combination of the word of the Lord, the spirit of God, the fire of God, the glory of the Lord, he's coming to cook us. This is the world's going to be a one big sauna.
Seuraavalla kerralla jatkamme katsomalla, miten tämä maailmanhistoriassa uuden vaiheen aloittanut konferenssi toteutui Israelissa. Rukoillaan vielä yhdessä. Kiitos Isä kirkkautesi paluusta Jerusalemiin. Kiitos siitä, että se, mikä toteutuu Jerusalemissa, kertautuu kansakunnissa. Kiitos Isä tästä ihmeellisestä uudesta kirkkauden aikakaudesta. Poikasi Jeesuksen nimessä. Aamen.
Näiden kuningaskunnan tuuliohjelmien tuotantoa voit tukea myös taloudellisesti. Tuen voit antaa helposti soittamalla ruudussa näkyvään puhelinnumeroon 0600 101 77. Puhelun hinta on noin 12 euroa. Voit antaa lahjoituksesi myös suoraan pankkitilille, jonka numero näkyy ruudussa.